We are running.
It was everything I touched on TV turned to shit. I'm now just sitting out here doing nothing. I ain't had no money. Borrowing money left and right. I decided to fuck it. I said, I'm just going to do stand-up comedy and focus on my craft. And I slaved the road for about 5 years doing the same circuit over and over again.
I hate that people act like they don't have a choice, you know? Here's one thing that I'll say to your listeners. And when I say it, think about it. Do you know how much energy and time it takes to be angry? Do you know how much time it takes to hold a grudge? To really muster up the energy to hold on to a grudge. I don't like you. Every time I see you, I gotta let you know I don't like you. I don't like you. That's energy.
Right.
That's
feels
energy
bad
that
too.
I'm throwing all this stuff your way. And that's energy that I could use to go into something else. Like when I think about my time, I think about my energy. I think about my efforts. How much time and energy do I really have? And how much do I want to put into stuff that's not going to affect me on a day-to-day basis?
It's just negative, just nonsense.
Nonsense. I mean, what? I don't have the time for it. That's why the negativity that I have received, I respond with kindness.
I don't want to do something and not be known for what I did in my generation. I want to stand out. So why not try to make history, which is why I did the football stadium. You know, 53,000 people is nothing to be frowned upon, but what you got to look at is a comedian has never done it.
I'm not going to sit inside of a corporation for 20 years. The time is now. The time is now to express and for people to believe in themselves. The time is now for it to be okay to be great. People in this world shun people for being great, for being a bright color, for standing out. But the time is now to be okay to be the greatest you.
Whatever world you stay in needs to know that I've never done a publicity stunt in my life. Anytime I went up and spoke my mind, whether it put my career in jeopardy or whatever someone so-called said, it was always what I thought was the truth, whether I'm like reading through a teleprompter or whatever I felt emotionally. I don't follow like rules of like, you know, normal celebrity or what their publicist tells them to say or anything. When I say things the wrong way, a lot of times my intention is always positive and I want to bring more things to the world. I want to help the world. I want to make people's lives easier. That's something extremely fearless for someone in my position to do, because most people just like, you know, bow down to TV or whatever, bow down to these cameras. Like, I could care less about any of these cameras, in all honesty. All I care about is my family. I care about protecting my girl, protecting my baby, and protecting my ideas and my dream. But you're gonna love me, or you're gonna hate me, but I'm gonna be me.
Our Father Christ Jesus, thank you so much for bringing me to the home where I was born, when my mother met my daddy, and when my mother met my daddy. Thank you for saving me, for replenishing me, for delivering me. When I found out about you and got closer to you, I got closer to my children. I got closer to my family. Because the devil had me chasing a gold statue. Had me chasing cars, had me chasing numbers. We didn't know what Billboard was when we was first making music back in Chicago. Back when I was 14 in my mama's crib, we didn't know what the numbers was. Now I'd be all over the internet like, oh, you only sold this much. The power of God cannot be calculated by a number, by a first week sale, by a bank account, by how many cars you drive, by how big your house is, and how many acres you got. It's God inside of us. It's God inside of family. It's God inside of friendships that we hold each other accountable. If you see somebody slipping, you tell them. I've seen him work miracles in my life. Work miracles in our life. You know, the devil presents so many flashy, shiny objects. I've seen everything that the devil could have showed you via TV, videos, car dealerships, jewelry, houses. And I tell you, nothing beats God.
Philosophies, and there's something creative down inside of you saying, let there be.